I didn't know I'd spend my Friday night crying over Steven Universe, but here we are. The latest two episodes, Together Forever and Growing Pains, are some of the most emotional we've seen from Steven Universe Future. These are the episodes that take Steven Universe Future into territory few shows, let alone cartoons, have dared to tread. I'm Kris Carr, and today I'm talking to you about how Steven Universe Future just got real. Before we dive into these episodes, I want to give a shout out to all of our supporters on Patreon. Thanks to these gems, we get to watch SUF together and talk about the latest events. Your monies help us stay afloat, and me, Wit, producer Brett, and editor Song couldn't appreciate y'all more. If you want to keep our ramen bowls full, head on over to our Patreon page and see if a donation tier works for you. If you'd rather use your cash to clothe yourself, then click that link to TeePublic in this video's description. They have awesome Steven Universe swag to choose from. On to Steven! We start the episode with Steven and Connie FaceTiming while Connie is on her 15-minute study break. Our brainy gal is sharing her college plans with Steven and really sounds like she's got it all figured out and has even narrowed down what major she's into. This is amazing. I went into undergrad undeclared, and then English, and then communications. No clue what I wanted to do. I was a fart in the wind. Not Connie. She's a lady with a plan. If Steven didn't know how to answer what grade he was in, our guy definitely feels out of his depth when it comes to uni talk. This conversation, coupled with Steven realizing how far away Connie's dream school is from Beach City, makes Steven worry about his friend leaving him behind. In this saved universe, Steven doesn't know what he wants to do or what his future has in store for him. He's so uncertain about everything, while Connie has her whole life trajectory mapped out. Feeling even more unsure about himself than he has lately, Steven turns to Garnet for help sorting out his feelings. Garnet, however, isn't available this time. She's defused and Ruby and Sapphire are off to do their own things. Sapphire is teaching a course on how to use psychic math to uncover alternative timelines and probabilities, and Ruby is taking her scout troop out into the wilderness for painting. So, Steven turns to them for help, and both tell him he should propose to Connie?
Do it, Steven. Do it. Do it. Do it!
Marrying her will fix all his problems. Well, this is terrible advice. Y'all, please, please don't propose to your significant other when you're 16 and sad and want them to save you. Don't propose to your partner when you're 30 and sad and want someone to save you. Even if it earns you a sweet engagement merit badge. I really want one of those. I earned mine. Whitney, make me a marriage patch for my jacket, please. Sure, marriage is obviously great for Ruby and Sapphire, who have dated forever and love being fused to one another. But this is not the route a teenager should take to fix their feelings of loneliness and anxiety. I will give it to Steven that this would be a pretty great proposal later on in life. He takes Connie to the beach where they met, which is a choice move. Propose in a significant spot. He lays out an adorable picnic. He sings her a cute original song about how he loves being an us. But the question doesn't land for college-minded Connie, especially since Steven suggested they get married and fuse as Stevani forever. This is an insane proposition for a human. Fusion, as we've seen through the show, is a beautiful illustration of multiple types of love and embodies trust, consent, and connection. Even with this understanding, long-term fusion among gems is something we don't see that often, and mixed fusions are fairly new to the fold, with Garnet breaking those societal boundaries when she formed. So asking any gem to permafuse is a big ask. Asking a human to do that? This is incredibly gem-biased. Why should Connie forsake her humanity, her independence? At best, this is a selfish idea, and at worst, it's downright creepy. Let me be with you for school, for every new moment, because I don't know how to navigate my own life. Let me live yours. Despite this crazy ask, Connie lets Steven down gently. She says her answer is a not right now, not a flat out no, and that while she loves being Stevani, she also loves being herself. Steven seems to think that being with Connie will fix everything he's been feeling for the past 12 episodes. And honestly, this is something you see a lot in real life. Some people think taking their relationship to the next level will solve all their problems. I assure you, it won't. I know some folks in the comments haven't agreed with me about you've got to love yourself before you can love someone else, and I totally get people feeling that way. But a successful partnership means you have your own things going on. You like who you are. You can bring all this positive energy to your partner. When you're down, of course they'll be there for you. But if you view a person as a safety net, you're gonna fall on them. A lot. Steven handles the rejection seemingly well, telling Connie that she should get back to studying and they'll talk later. All before turning pink and causing a crater in the sand from his emotions. The episode does a beautiful job of tinging everything with pink as that no settles in. The sand, the ocean. It really reinforces that Steven is having an incredibly difficult time. Garnet comes to comfort Steven and delivers some tough love that really got to me because this is something my husband says all the time. Your soulmate shouldn't complete you. They should complement you. She's right. No one is going to be your missing piece. You can't expect someone to make you whole and fix the things you think are wrong with you. Frankly, that's selfish. You have to work on yourself. You have to be an active participant in a relationship and give your all. Steven wants to marry Connie for all the wrong reasons. And even though it really sucks and freaking hurts to get turned down, you've got to allow yourself to feel everything that comes with rejection. Feeling that pain is okay. It helps you process it. But processing isn't really Steven's thing in this series, is it? Instead, he mopes around the house at the beginning of the next episode, Growing Pains, trying to avoid speaking with Connie about what went down. He does try to talk to his dad, but when he hears how happy Greg is on his tour, he pulls the classic Steven move of acting like everything is fine, guilty that he could potentially diminish his father's happiness with where he is in life. So, Steven doesn't get to talk about this new, upsetting situation with Connie. Instead, his body grows and swells in bizarro ways as he glows pink. Thankfully, Connie FaceTimes Steven, witnesses these bizarre symptoms, and takes Steven to see her mom at the hospital. While there, we get a great bit about how when the crystal gems were previously x-rayed for educational purposes, the only image capable of being captured is that of the gem's actual gem. This makes sense as these extraterrestrial beings' appearances are actually projections from their gemstones. Y'all, I cannot express to you how important this episode is. Steven Universe has always been ready and willing to talk about mental health through its characters, exploring and explaining to its audience about the effects of PTSD, depression, and abuse. But this episode takes things to a new level. This is a flat-out clinical analysis of Steven's health, physically and mentally. Rarely do you see something like this in animation, let alone something that's touted as a children's cartoon. Connie's mother, who, like me, was horrified that Steven had never been to a doctor and that Greg really dropped the ball there, administers a series of tests on Steven. She shows him an x-ray that reveals he's had multiple fractures that have healed themselves. This diamond has cracks in it. The bones healing themselves seems to reflect how Steven has handled his emotions, on his own. As I've said in my previous Steven Universe Future videos, Steven is a fixer, and he certainly has been trying to fix himself on his own, just as he healed those breaks and contusions. Connie's mother breaks down what trauma is for Steven. These injuries indicate that he's experienced a lot of trauma in his life, and goes on to explain how the loss of his support system could exacerbate feelings he hasn't come to terms with yet. We're given a montage of some of the dangers and horrors Steven has faced. Near-death experiences, witnessing others' technical deaths and injuries, and it feels to me like this is the first time Steven has ever even considered how all these events could have had a lasting effect on him. It finally dawns on him that he's been through so much and doesn't know how to process what he went through. This scene also forces us, the audience, to address that the series' predecessor, Steven Universe, was a lot darker than we gave it credit. Confronting his past coupled with Connie's rejection is too much for Steven, who grows and glows more. According to Connie's mother, Steven's body is now reacting to minor stress as if his life is in danger. Why? Well, that's all Steven has ever known. He's the intergalactic savior of the universe, and he knows how to survive. How can he gauge a reaction when all he's known since his youth were life or death scenarios? Thankfully, Connie found Greg, who comes home early from his tour to help care for Steven, and he encourages his son to talk about the things that have been happening to him. While Steven does tell his father about what happened and how little things make him feel overwhelmed, that he doesn't know how to live if he constantly feels like he's dying, he then reverts back to his old ways of being riddled with guilt for making Dad return home and listen to his problems. This kind of thing is true for a lot of people. They think they'll burden folks with their problems, that they won't be fun. And we talked about that being a constant fear of Steven's when we discussed his relationships with Peridot and Connie in the previous two episodes. While I was feeling hopeful about Steven's emotional journey becoming a healthy one with episodes 11 and 12, I'm less sure now. I'm so happy he's finally looking at his past, that he's talking about some of the pain he's feeling. But I don't know if he's going to examine the events of his youth in a healthy way. That's a lot of trauma to unpack. And like I said, Steven isn't solid at processing stuff. Ugh, And we've got to talk about that line, you guys. How do I live if I feel like I'm dying? Oh, it honestly made me cry. Existing can be so freaking hard. How many times have you or a friend just been sad and you aren't sure why? Addressing his trauma is a great step for Steven, but reopening old wounds is never easy. Things are definitely gonna get worse before they can get better. Just look at that line about Steven not being able to handle these quote unquote Era 3 problems.
The Earth is safe, it's Era 3, but I'm swelling up over these third era problems.
This is essentially saying that what he's going through are first world problems, which aren't worthy of people's time. By minimizing his problems and their emotional toll, he continues to diminish his pain, further burying his feelings. While I can appreciate him being self-aware enough to know the issues that are triggering him currently seem like molehills compared to the mountains he's conquered in the past, he's doing himself a disservice. Like Steven, we have to face hardships in our own lives head on. We need to ask for help. And if you think a friend or a loved one is struggling, even if they say they're fine, you get on in there. You aren't weak for admitting you're drowning a bit. Ask for that life preserver. No one will think less of you. And if you're truly worried, do what me and Whit do. Ask, do you have the mental real estate for me to unload some stuff with you? Works great. I'm so, so thankful for this incredible creative team for tackling trauma, because this show spelling out what it is plain and simple is gonna help so many people. Our cute pastel-riddled show about love and giant women has gotten so raw and real and honest. And it feels like this is a conversation that they're just getting started with us. Our next two episodes are titled Mr. Universe and Fragments. Fragments definitely doesn't make me feel good about what's in store for Steven. Mr. Universe could be about Steven or Greg, or maybe even their relationship with one another. Fingers crossed we'll get a Steg appearance. Let me know what you're expecting in the upcoming episodes and how you felt about Together Forever and Growing Pains. Thanks again to everyone on Patreon, TeePublic, and all of y'all who came in to join the discussion. For more videos, you can click to the left. Thanks for watching, y'all. See you, Space Cowboy.